kann dir nur in Nachricht und in Frieden singen mir, singen mir. Hey there, friends, Mark here on the Culinary Compass, ready to talk to you about one of my favorite things in the whole world, roast chicken, and what comes underneath that roast chicken, which is this beautiful fat and pieces of kind of caramelized, crispy fat. Very rarely does any of this make it on top of the chicken for basting or for use for making a sauce, as in I sop up with a nice hard Italian or French bread the fat as it's cooking. If you do have some pieces that you can scrape out and not eat right there and then at the moment, and you can let them cool down, you end up with these pieces of grimness, hard kind of chicken bacon, and that of course can be used for all types of things. Just think of where you'd use bacon and replace this. One of the things that's wonderful to do is to take the liquids as opposed to just the solids, and take them, pour them out, and drain it through a colander of some type, a fine sieve, into a jar. And this is going to become a thing called schmalz, which is basically hardened chicken fat without the solids themselves. So you put it in a ball jar, put it in the refrigerator, and an hour or 2 hours later, you're going to end up with this hard yellow thing, which is schmaltz. And underneath, you'll see the solids will fall down. Now, you also can buy this stuff. And basically, schmaltz, you should just think of it as a spread in its most basic form. And, here's what it looks like. And I tend to use it on bread. I will just toast up a nice hard bread and smear it right on top. But you also can use it for sauteing, like you would use butter or oil. I tend to enjoy using it for roasting vegetables, the flavor that comes through. Now, olive oil, of course, is a go-to as well, but if you have schmaltz, you've got to try it. It really adds wonderful flavor. And finally, just play with it. Here you can see I put some garlic in tinfoil and roasted it, and you can see the results. So, schmaltz, grimness, go for it.